President Marcos launches the Kadiwa program in San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, Wednesday in a bid to address the rising prices of commodities in the country. Marcos says the program also aims to help small businesses get back on track following the massive effects of the pandemic.
Kaya naman po, dahan-dahan namin ibinabawi lahat yan upang naman may mapagbigyan ang ating mga kababayan na meron naman makukuhang pagkain, may makukuhang bilihin, lalo na sa agricultural products ay marami naman ay na hindi na kaya ng ating mga household o pangkaraniwan na household na Pilipino. At bukod pa doon, ang Kadiwa, ang aming ginagawa ay binibigyan din namin ng pagkakataon yung mga local na maliliit na negosyo. Kaya magpapasalamat ako sa inyong lahat na nakilahok dito, lalong-lalo na sa ating mga local government, dahil hindi po kaya ng DA lamang, hindi po kaya ng national government lamang kung walang tulong at walang magandang partnership sa ating mga local government.
President Marcos also led the groundbreaking ceremony of the Pambansang Pabahay para sa Filipino Housing Project in Bulacan.
Ito ay bahagi ng programa ng inyong pamahalaan na 1,000,000 bahay sa iba't ibang dako ng bansa sa bawat na taon sa Administrasyon Marcos. Ang proyektong ito ay isa sa mga mahalagang programa na pagtutugunan natin ng pansin dahil sa malaking kakulangan ng pabahay dito sa ating bansa. Kaya naman po, nais kong personal na matunghayan ang pagkakataong ito at tiyakin na ang proyekto ay masisimulan at matatapos sa nakatakdang oras.
Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez meets with U.S. House Majority Leader Steve Scalise in a visit to Washington. The lawmakers discussed improving ties between the Philippines and the U.S. Romualdez believes relations between the two countries will remain stronger under the Marcos administration. The Philippine delegation is also comprised of Manila's envoy, Jose Manuel Romualdez, and other lawmakers, including House Majority Leader Manuel Jose Dalipe. A Filipino family racially attacked in California last year, dismayed over a ruling saying the incident was not a hate crime. As the Evangelist tells us, the family vows to continue their fight for justice.
Justice for the Rockies!
Justice for the Rockies!
A California judge has ruled that the Asian hate case involving a Filipino family will indeed go to trial after going through preliminary hearings. But the suspect in the Roque family's case, Nicholas Weber, will not face hate crime enhancements in his charges, which include two felony battery counts.
It's really disappointing how we've been treated so far and how the justice system has been treating this case when it's really obvious that this is a hate crime. What more do we need? I think it's really obvious from the video that it was a hate crime.
Activists who have supported the Roque family took to the courtyard after the ruling, ready to continue their fight for justice. Since the alleged attack against the Filipino family almost a year ago, the victims are still recovering from their trauma and injuries.
This is not the end. This is just always been the beginning of something.
While disappointed that the hate crime enhancements were dropped, these activists say they weren't surprised with the ruling. California Department of Justice statistics show that from 2015 to 2021, less than half of hate crimes filed by district attorneys and city attorneys have resulted in a conviction. The video from the May 2022 incident shows Weber hurling anti-Asian remarks and threatening to kill Narissa Roque and her daughter Patricia after his Jeep rear-ended their vehicle in a fast food drive-thru. Minutes later, as Weber tried to enter the vehicle, Narissa's husband Gabriel arrived at the scene to confront Weber. The physical attack resulted in Gabriel suffering from a broken rib. Weber then went on to grab Narissa by the neck. The video also shows Weber harassing another person during the incident. Despite what transpired in the videos, the judge ruled that the sequence of events did not show that the physical attack was bias motivated. The judge did rule that Weber's physical attack on Gabriel caused significant bodily injury.
Because the hateful words that Weber said happened minutes before the assault, that there is no probable cause for a hate crime. And the tragedy is that those 2 minutes, those few minutes were enough for them to say that that wasn't a hate crime. But the Roque family has to live for the rest of their lives knowing that they were assaulted because they were Asian.
Yep.
That's unfair.
File petition.
That's unfair, and that's why we're angry, right?
Yeah.
Because what we witnessed up there is not justice.
Nicholas Weber is scheduled to appear in court on May 1st for an arraignment, just days before the one-year anniversary of when this incident first happened. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Van Nuys, California.